Welcome to tonight's contest. Here are your Rochester High School varsity players.
I'm Luke Kennedy, number 40, and I'm a forward.
Alec Garrick, senior, number 24, forward.
I'm Brandon Camp, I'm a senior, and I'm a shooting guard.
I'm Carter Screen, I'm a senior, and I play point guard.
Brett Abbott, shooting guard, sophomore.
I'm Alec Holland, I'm a sophomore and a guard.
Matthew Bastrom, senior, forward.
Dom Thomas, I'm a junior, and power forward.
Noah Dahlquist, junior, center.
Taylor Medina, I'm a junior and a forward.
So it'll be Kennedy and also Jellison to jump center. Rochester on the home whites, 59-36. Yes, sir. And casting in their home reds. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. We are ready for the varsity contest. Rochester looking for the hat trick as they have won both a freshman game and the junior varsity game tonight. The tip goes out of bounds. They're going to say they're not sure who tipped it out, so we're going to re-jump. Kennedy and Jellison to jump. The ball is up, and the tip controlled by Cass into the backcourt. Quentin Douglas will bring it up the floor. Douglas across the timeline for the Comets. Rochester starts, surprisingly enough, in that 2-3 zone.
Going to give them their keep the height advantage down low. Try and take the rebounding advantage.
Kingery has it stripped away and stolen by Holland, Alec Garrick, and he loses it off his knee and out of bounds, so Cass are going to get it back.
Well, Garrick did a good job of stepping into the passing lane on that one and taking that ball away, but he wasn't able to finish it at the other end.
30 seconds gone in the first quarter. No score. Cass with the basketball going to our right. Quickly, Jellison has it. Now to Douglas. Now right side to Kingery. Looks at a three. Passes up. Good job by the 2-3 zone to get out there behind the arc to stop that shot.
Yeah, they're being mobile, that zone is.
Kingery tries to force a pass inside, taken away by Kennedy, and Luke gives off to Holland. So you heard Coach Ryan Holt in the pregame say we're going to be awfully methodical here in this basketball game. We're going to pass, we're going to pass, we're going to pass, and we're looking for something 5 feet in unless we get a wide-open three-pointer.
Right.
I'm talking wide open.
Casting in a man-to-man, so they're going to have to be setting some good picks, and they've got some movement.
Kennedy for three is good. Luke Kennedy puts the Zebras on the board first. It's 3-0 with 6:46 to play in the first quarter. Douglas works left side. Now the elbow ball passed away and taken away from Hadashell. Kennedy has it. Now to Screeton. Screeton across the timeline right. He'll work against Douglas in the backcourt. Now high on the right side to Garrick. One dribble. Jump pass in the corner to Screeton and out of bounds. A little too tall for Carter to handle. And Rochester going to give it back to the cast of Comets.
A little over a week ago when Rochester played Whitco, Kennedy had 3 three-pointers in that first quarter.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah. It's good to see him get off a good start. Rochester still in that 2-3 zone. Jellison over the top of the defense to Douglas. Crossover dribble just inside the arc. Pulls up for two. No good. Long rebound to Screeton. Rochester runs to our left. 3-0 Zebras in the corner to Medina. Medina back to Screeton high on the right side. Now to Garrick. Garrick on the right wing to Holland. He travels.
Both teams trading turnovers right here at the first beginning of the game.
Uh-oh. And Coach Reinholt wants a timeout. It will be a 30. You're listening to Zebra Basketball.
For over a century, Rochester Telephone Company has been connecting our community, family to family, friend to friend, business to business. It is the people of RTC, your friends, your neighbors, who have made the difference. Times may have changed, but our tradition of excellent service still remains in our family of dedicated employees that serve you. RTC, a part of Rochester's past, present, and future.
Six minutes to play, first quarter after the Rochester timeout. The Comets have it. Hadashell quickly to Douglas. Douglas in the lane, kicks into the corner. To Kingery. His three on the way is good, and we're tied at three. Kingery had a wide-open three-point shot, and he buried it. And that's exactly what, Brad, we just talked about in a couple of minutes ago in the pregame.
Yeah, you're right. They're not going to hesitate to take the open shots.
Alec Garrick's jumper from the elbow is no good. Rebound to the Comets. Douglas hasn't run, and now Coach Reinholt will go to the bench. Kingery, right corner to Douglas. Left side to Jellison. Back to Douglas on the right side. Out the elbow now. Is inside the arc. Out to Jellison. He'll spot up from three in the left wing. No good. Rebound fall four. Kasten has it. Now Carter Screeton takes it away from him. Screeton runs for Rochester. We're tied at three. 5:10 to play in the first quarter. Screeton middle of the floor. Now left side to Kennedy. 6'4 stands atop the key behind the arc. Now to Holland. Alec, one dribble. Gives it up. Now to Screeton on the right wing. Screeton. To elbow at the elbow to Medina, and Medina has it tipped out of bounds by the cast of Comets, and it'll stay with Rochester right in front of the Comet bench. And Brett Abbott into the game for the first time, and Alec Garrick will sit. We're tied at three with 4:55 to play in the first quarter. As Screeton will look to trigger it in. Screeton gets it into Abbott near the timeline, who gives off to Holland. We're tied at three here early in the ballgame at Rochester High School. Casting the man-to-man defense. Abbott stands behind the arc in the right corner. Now gives to Screeton. Steps back now to Kennedy on the left wing behind the arc. Kennedy, ball above his head, gives in the corner to Abbott. Abbott, top to Screeton. Three in the way. Is good, and Rochester back up 6-3. Good to see the senior Carter Screeton looking for his shot and knocking it down. Rochester into 2-3 zone.
He got a good screen at the top of the key.
Out of shell, gives to Kingery. Runs away from the defense. Down the corner to Offenberger. Back to Kingery. Top to Douglas. Looks at the three. Passes it up. Nice recovery by the Zebra 2-3 zone. In the corner to Offenberger. Three on the way. Is off the back of the iron. No good. Kennedy with the board. And gives to Screeton. Quickly ahead to Abbott. Abbott jump stops. Out to Screeton. Now top of the key to Kennedy. Luke holds. Now drives it left. Has it stripped away by Hadashell to Screeton. Rochester has it going to our left. Holland now with the basketball, looking down low to Medina. Medina jump stops, rises up, shots good, and a foul!
Nice to see Medina get his shot to fall. He's been working awful hard down there the last couple trips to get a post position.
Rochester up 8-3, and Taylor Medina at the line to shoot one free throw. And Brandon Camp for the Zebras coming in for the first time, and Holland to sit. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman.
Number two, Brandon Camp.
Medina at the line to try to complete the three-point play the old-fashioned way and put the Zebras up by six. He eyes the free throws in and out. No good. Cast into the board. Jellison skies to the board. Has it. Now Douglas will bring it up. Quentin Douglas across the timeline right. Rochester still in a 2-3 zone. Now left side to Jellison. High on the left side. Back to Douglas. High on the near side. To Jellison. He'll fire a three left side way too hard. And the offensive rebound to Offenberger. He puts it back up. No good. Kennedy skies to the board. Offenberger has it. His put back. No good. But a foul coming on the Zebras. And that's going to send Dustin Offenberger to the line to shoot two. Kennedy was above the rim to try to grab the board. Unfortunately for him, it bounced again on the front of the rim and kind of threw off the rebound.
I was going to say, timing. That he thought he had it timed just right, but the ball took an extra bounce off the front of the rim, and Offenberger was able to come up with it.
So Dustin Offenberger, a 6'1 junior at the line to shoot two for the Comets. The first one on the way is good. Rochester by five. We'll make that four now. One more free throw coming. Alec Garrig will come back in. And Garrig will replace Taylor Medina for the Rochester Zebras. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. 3:25 to play in the first quarter. Rochester by four. And Offenberger at the line for one more freebie for his Comets. Second on the way is good. 8-5. Rochester picked up at the timeline. Camp drives in the paint, kicks it out to Abbott, Screeton. Camp again on the left baseline. One dribble left wing to Kennedy. Kennedy to Garrig. Garrig back to Screeton on the right wing. Top to Camp. Left side to Garrig. Garrig backs his way in the paint, travels.
His first option to pass was covered up. He tried to throw it off in the corner and shuffled his feet.
Eli Douglas, a 5'10 freshman for Kasten, comes in, and sitting down is Hadashell. Quentin Douglas will bring it up the floor. Rochester by three with three to play in the first quarter. Rochester still defensively in that 2-3 zone. Right side to Kingery, left side to Eli Douglas. Quentin Douglas top of the key. Back to Eli left wing. Feeds in the baseline to Jellison. Out to Douglas. Drives it. Kicks it out to Eli. Eli Douglas in the left wing. Now to Quentin Douglas between the rings of the volleyball line. Down low to Kingery. Fakes. Jumper. No good. Ball tipped around. Cassa comes out of there with it. Quentin Douglas drives. Shot over Kennedy. And we're going to have a
charge on going to call charge on Douglas.
That call literally was 5 seconds after contact.
You're right.
I think it was the right call, but it was awfully late. Two and a half to play first quarter. Rochester up 8-5.
Well, Kennedy had great position down low when Douglas drove in.
Screeton kicks in the corner to Cam. Now top of the key to Garrett. Right side Abbott. Abbott dumps it into Kennedy. Kennedy on the block. Loses the handle. Gets it back. Got to get rid of it. It's going to be a 5 second call, and Fish finally does right before the 5 second call to Garrick. Now top to Camp, left side to Abbott. Behind the arc of the Zebras, down low to Garrick. In the paint, rises up, off the window, and good. Rochester back by five. Kangaroo in the right corner for the Comets. Dribbles to the wing. Now bounce pass top of Douglas. Quentin Douglas in the paint. Jump pass down low is out of bounds. And that was a tough pass for Jellison to handle, and it goes back to Rochester.
That was a tough pass to make. He probably would have been better off trying to put it up over the rim.
Alec Holland back into the game, and Screeton to sit. 1:54 to play first quarter. Rochester up 10-5, and casting a little man-to-man pressure in the backcourt. Actually, they're going to say it's going to be almost a trap.
Coach Howell trying to create some kind of turnover opportunities.
Abbott in the lane, dumps it to Garrig. His layup is good. Alec Garrig has two more, and Rochester by seven. Eli Douglas, now to Kingery, back to Quentin Douglas in the right corner to Offenberger. His jumper's off the mark. Garrig with the rebound, saves it from going out of bounds, right into the hands of Kennedy, and Rochester runs. Kennedy, back door to Abbott, gets it on the blocks, puts it up, no good. And the rebound to Kasten.
Abbott kind of lost his footing, and he still just about got it on.
Quentin Douglas at the elbow, backs it outside. Now to Offenberger to Eli Douglas. Runs the baseline, and he is going to be fouled on the drive by Kennedy. It's going to be out of bounds to the Kasten Comets. Minute four to play in the first quarter. Rochester up 12-5. And Matt Basham comes in for the first time for the Rochester Zebras. And he'll replace Kennedy. Back in for Kasten is Hadashell, and Kingery comes out. Jellison, no-look pass into Quentin Douglas. Looks at a three, drives it inside the lane. Kicks it out to King, makes that to Jellison. Now to Eli Douglas, quickly to Quentin Douglas. Back to Eli on the right wing. Eli against a 2-3 zone, dribbles away from Camp, picks it up, and has it knocked out of bounds. It's passed by Camp, and it'll stay with Kasten right in front of the Rochester bench with 47 seconds to play in the first quarter.
Well, Camp and Holland on the points of this 2-3 zone doing a really good job of getting out and into the face of the ball handler.
Extending that zone sometimes in the volleyball line.
They are. That zone's really mobile, sliding back and forth across the paint.
35 seconds to play first quarter. Rochester up 12-5. Eli Douglas has it on the right wing. One dribble back to Quentin Douglas, top of the key. Stands in the center circle, back to Eli. And now we're going to have a foul inside, as I believe Offenberger was fouled trying to go to the basket. We'll see. Wait and see who that's going to be whistled against.
Going to get Holland on that one, his first, team third.
26 and a half to play in the first quarter. Rochester up 12-5. Jellison looks to get it in. Does so to Eli Douglas on the right corner. He dribbles to the top of the key to Quentin with 20. Quentin Douglas back to Eli Douglas, high on the right side. Back to Quentin Douglas in the center circle. Back to Eli Douglas on the right wing. Back to Quentin, 13. Now to Jellison with 10. Back to Quentin Douglas near the timeline with 8. Jellison with 6. Back to Quentin Douglas with 5. Drives it, travel, no call. Out to Jellison with 2. 3 on the way at the buzzers, no good. After 1, Rochester leads 12-5. You're listening to High School Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Hi, I'm Katie Seiler, 2013 graduate of Rochester High School. The Babcock Scholarship was established by Charles and Elizabeth Babcock for Rochester High School students and graduates. Juniors and seniors interested in taking dual credit classes and applying for the Babcock Scholarship can pick one up at Mrs. Horn's desk. If you are a junior or senior taking dual credit classes, don't hesitate to fill out the Babcock Scholarship. In the past, all applicants have received money to help fund their education.
Shepherd Chevrolet Buick in Rochester is the place for all of your automotive service needs.
I've been coming to Shepherd's for service approximately 5 or 6 years. My husband drives the Honda 2004, I believe, so it isn't brand new. And he brings it here. We get our tires here, oil changes, whatever needs to be done, they take care of. We have a good history with the Shepherd family, so we're happy to come here.
second quarter we go here at Rochester High School. The Zebras leading it 12-5, and Rochester will start with the basketball going to our left here in the second quarter. Again, the Rochester Lady Zebras defeated North Judson tonight on the road on a makeup game 59-36. Congratulations to Coach Tony Stasiak and the girls. They're back in action on Saturday night here, senior night, believe it or not. We're about time of year again, aren't we?
It's going by fast.
Abbott on the baseline is fouled by Eli Douglas on the entry pass. It'll be out of bounds to Rochester baseline left with 11 seconds gone in the second quarter. Abbott to get it in. Lob pass to Garrick. Catches it in midair, throws it up in midair, no good. And Offenberger with a rebound.
That's a great idea.
Yep.
Just bounced off the front.
Had a great look, and it was down and came out. Offenberger out to Quinton Douglas. 2-3 zone by the Zebras. Right side to Kingery. Down low to Hadashell. Outside to Eli Douglas, three top of the key is good. Eli Douglas, a 5'10 freshman, buries it from downtown and cuts the lead to three. How about four? Three, but Camp is good. Three and in Camp with three in the left corner. Puts the Zebras back up by seven. And then Garrick knocks the basketball out of bounds on a pass, and it'll stay with Caston in front of the Rochester bench.
I was going to say, the one thing the 2-3 zone for Rochester is doing is keeping Caston away from the basket. They haven't had a lot of looks down low. Not a lot of dribble penetration either.
Yeah,
so
you're right.
That three by Eli Douglas was a big shot for them.
Kind of closes it up, and like you say, yeah. Brandon Camp at the top of that key is causing all sorts of havoc.
Yeah.
Kingery to Eli Douglas, dribbles inside the three-point line. Down the corner to Hadashell. Hadashell being mauled in the corner. Now to Offenberger. Offenberger the basketball. Now to Kingery, right side to Quinton Douglas, who has been quiet in this game so far.
Yeah.
Down low to Offenberger, jumper off the glass, no good. And grabbed by the Rochester Zebras, and Garrick runs.
The height advantage in that 2-3 zone by Rochester really creating havoc.
Holland, one dribble, Camp high on the right side. Back to Garrick, behind the arc for the Rochester Zebras, baseline to Holland. Holly top of the key to Abbott, who sends the elbow to Basham outside to Camp. Camp one dribble to Abbott, quickly to Garrick, three in the way, left wing is no good, and the rebound to Quinton Douglas. Caston runs to our right. Rochester up by seven. Eli to Offenberger, Quinton top of the key. Quinton Douglas back to Offenberger, drives the baseline, runs over Basham, blocking foul going to be called on Basham, and it'll be out of bounds to Caston.
Basham will pick up his first, team fourth.
Back into the game for Rochester. Kennedy, Medina, and Screeton. Abbott, Basham, and Camp to come out. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. Second quarter here at Rochester. And we're going to have a charge coming against Offenberger, who cleared space before.
Well, I got the ball down low, which was a feat in itself. But when he turned around, he had Kennedy right in front of him. And Kennedy put it. Offenberger's first shot right back in his belly. In his second attempt, he tried to clear a little space. Got called for the charge.
So Rochester, the basketball going to our left, up by seven. 5:45 to play in the first half. Coming up at halftime, we're going to talk to freshman coach Joe McCarter about his season. You want to stay tuned for that. Holly for three. Nope, off the mark. And Luke Kennedy just picked up foul number two on the push.
Yeah.
And you heard Coach Reinhold, at least you should have, yell at young Alec Holland, that's not the kind of shot we want. That wasn't a very good choice. Let's work it around. Let's take advantage of our height. Five and a half to play first half. Eli Douglas high on the left side. Now to Kingery to Quinton Douglas on the right wing. Back to Kingery. Douglas on the right wing, drives it to the baseline, now backs it behind the three-point line to Kingery, loses the handle. Garrick picks it up, leads ahead to Holland, left-handed layup is good. 30-second timeout by the Comets. You're listening to High School Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
For over a century, Rochester Telephone Company has been connecting our community, family to family, friend to friend, business to business. It is the people of RTC, your friends, your neighbors, who have made the difference. Times may have changed, but our tradition of excellent service still remains in our family of dedicated employees that serve you.
RTC, a part of Rochester's past, present, and future.
8-8. Freshman basketball tonight. Rochester defeated Caston 40-27. The JV game went to Rochester over Caston 47-30. So, Brad, as we talked before, Rochester looking for the hat trick.
Yeah, the Coach Reinholdt challenged the team before tonight's game, and it looks like they're accepting that challenge.
I was going to say they've responded pretty well.
2-3 zone, but they're not sitting back in it waiting. They're coming out and being aggressive.
Well, I think that if you wait for the cast of Comets, they're going to bury
it. They'll bomb you.
Yeah, that's right. And then a steal coming for Rochester. It's Garrick there to pick up the loose ball, and he'll bring it up the floor going to our left and leading by 9. And now Screen has it, and they'll reset. Two-three zone for the cast of Comets now. Holland fakes the three to Garrick. Drives the baseline. Pulls up from 10 feet. No good off the mark. Rebound by Garrick. Put back is good.
That was just a case of not giving up on the play. Garrick missed the shot, but he stayed put and was able to get his own rebound and put it back in.
Ball tipped away. Screen has it. He tips it up the floor. Has it on the baseline now. Gives the left side to Kennedy. Kennedy to Streeton on the baseline. Boy, he looked at the three, and now good decision to reset. Yep. Holland high on the right side for Rochester, leading by 11, going to our left, under 4 to play in the first half. Kennedy at the free throw line. Oh, misses Garrick going through the lane. Down low to Medina. Taylor, jumper, good.
Medina does a good job of keeping himself under control and just using his physical assets to his advantage.
Cast with the basketball going to our right. Kingery, right wing to Jellison, and his pass is picked off by Garrick. Alec Garrick goes up for the right-handed layup, is no good. Kennedy fights for the board, still loose on the floor. Kennedy's putback is no good, but a foul coming on Caston. That's going to send Kennedy to the line to shoot two.
And that foul's coming against Alex Hadeshell, his second, team fifth.
And the line for the Zebras, number 40, Luke Kennedy. Kennedy shooting two.
So Luke Kennedy at the line to shoot two, with Rochester up 21-8. The first one with the big man is good.
Checking in for Caston, number 3, Graham Rensler. And
Graham Rensler in the game.
Dustin Offenberger.
For Caston, also Offenberger back in with 3:23 to play in the first half. Rochester up 22-8. Luke Kennedy for the Zebras with one more. Second one is good. Bashing back in. Kennedy will set with two fouls. 23-8 Rochester. 3:23 to play in the first half. Quinton Douglas on the run. Right side to Rensler. Rensler gets a double team. Tries to dribble away from Streeton and can't do that very well. In the corner to Jellison. Wrap around pass to Rensler. Eli Douglas to Quinton Douglas high on the left side.
Rochester doing a good job with that zone again. Just one step away from trapping in the corner.
And they have forced a lot of turnovers.
They have. Three in a row now.
Eli Douglas is called for a charge and he runs over Basham.
That's Douglas' second.
Under three to play in the first half. Rochester up 23-8. By far, Brad. By far the best first half of the year for the Zebras.
I would agree.
Screen with it. Crosses the timeline. Casting into 2-3 zone. Extended out to the volleyball line. Sends the high on the near side to Holland. Holland back to the right wing to Screeton. Screeton in the middle to Medina. 10-footer in the paint is no good. And the rebound to Quinton Douglas, who runs through the center circle. Quinton Douglas, middle of the floor, goes all the way to the basket. He's going to be fouled before the shot, I believe. And it'll be out of bounds to the Caston Comets.
Coming on Alec Holland, his first or second.
Number 4, Brett Abbott.
Brett Abbott back into the game. Brandon Camp back into the game. Holland and Medina to sit. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. Baseline right is Jellison for the Caston Comets. At 2:36 to play in the first half. Jellison looks, get it into wide open Offenberger, and he is fouled on the shot. He'll go to the line to shoot two.
Yeah, Offenberger got on the inside of Abbott and behind Basham, was able to get that pass inbounds. And
number 4, Brett Abbott.
All Abbott could do at that point was fouling.
Right. 23-8, Rochester on top. Dustin Offenberger's first one is good. I believe he's 3 of 3 from the line right now.
You're right.
One more coming. for the junior. Looking to cut this lead to 13. Offenberger eyes the second one, lets it fly, no good. Garrett with the board. Gives off to Screeton. Kasson slides back in that 2-3 zone to Garrett on the left wing, looks on the baseline, can't get it to Abbott, back to Screeton, right side, now to Camp. Camp holds and studies. Top of the key to Screeton, quickly left side to Garrett. Kasson in a 2-3 zone to Screeton. 2:15 to play in the first half. Rochester up by 14 at 23-9. Abbott back to Screeton. Screeton holds at the volleyball line right in the middle of the floor.
Yep, you got Basham working the post, and you got Abbott and Camp sliding back and forth across the baseline.
Kasson right now contend to let Rochester have it and run some clock here. We're under two to play in the first half. Screeton now holds. Now the defense extends out to the volleyball line to Gehrig, and he travels going to the basket. Again, the Rochester Lady Zebras defeated North Judson on the road tonight, 59-36. Eli Douglas high on the left side against the 2-3 zone. Dribbles around Camp. Top of the key now to Rensler. Now right wing, Jellison. Jellison a couple of dribbles to Quinton Douglas between the rings. Quinton Douglas now left wing to Rensler. Rensler back to Quinton Douglas. Now right side to Eli Douglas. Tries to force a pass inside, and Offenberger and Camp tied up. It'll stay with Kasson. Quinton Douglas has been silent in this first half.
He's just been a pivot man at the top of the point for Kasson. He hasn't been able to find any open driving lanes. And I would give that to Screeton and Camp and Abbott.
Yeah,
they've
I agree.
Really played the top of that zone very well.
2-3 zone for Rochester. Kasson with it. Jellison holds on the right side behind the arc with 1:10 to play in the first half. Quinton Douglas high on the left side. Now right side to Eli Douglas. Three on the way again from the wing. Is off the mark, no good. Abbott with a rebound for Rochester, and the Zebras run. Screeton with the basketball. 60 seconds to play first half. Rochester up by 14. And we'll probably look for the final shot of the period if Kasson will allow that. 2-3 zone extended out to the volleyball line. Abbott holds about five steps inside the 10-second line. Screeton with 45 seconds holds, directs traffic. Gives to Garrick at the timeline with 40. Garrick holds, dribbles to the left side, gives to Screeton with 37. Screeton loses the handle and then over the back ball. He's got his palms to the sky. What did I do? But he regained possession before stepping over the 10-second line.
Right. The ball got tipped away, but he grabbed it before he crossed over.
35 seconds to play, first half. Rochester up 23-9, and Kasson with it going to our right. Eli Douglas dribbles away from trouble. Now to Quinton Douglas, now high on the right side to Rensler. Rensler over the top of the defense to Quinton Douglas at the timeline. Left side to Eli Douglas, back to Quinton Douglas, and he holds in the center circle at 15.
Be aware of Jellison running the baseline. Basham getting pulled up towards the free throw line.
Quinton Douglas moves with 8. Quinton Douglas with 6. Drives it left side to Jellison with 4. Jellison around the defense to Quinton Douglas with 1. 3 at the buzzers on the way. Good! At halftime, Rochester leads 23-12. You're listening to high school basketball, 92.1 WROI.
For over a century, Rochester Telephone Company has been connecting our community. Family to family, friend to friend, business to business. It is the people of RTC, your friends, your neighbors, who have made the difference. Times may have changed, but our tradition of excellent service still remains in our family of dedicated employees that serve you. RTC, a part of Rochester's past, present, and future.
Shepherd Chevrolet Buick in Rochester is the place for all of your automotive service needs.
I've been coming to Shepherd's for service approximately 5 or 6 years. My husband drives the Honda 2004, I believe, so it isn't brand new. And he brings it here. We get our tires here, oil changes, whatever needs to be done, they take care of. We have a good history with the Shepherd family, so we're happy to come here.
RTC makes it easy with the new Triple Play Combo. Now you can enjoy the best of cable, internet, and phone for one low package price. Get all of the features that they want at a price you can afford. The Triple Play Combo, another great offer
from RTC.
Hi, I'm Katie Seiler, 2013 graduate of Rochester High School. The Babcock Scholarship was established by Charles and Elizabeth Babcock for Rochester High School students and graduates. Juniors and seniors interested in taking dual credit classes and applying for the Babcock Scholarship can pick one up at Mrs. Horn's desk. If you are a junior or senior taking dual credit classes, don't hesitate to fill out the Babcock Scholarship. In the past, all applicants have received money to help fund their education.
To create anything, but they've taken an element of his offense off the floor, and he needs to find it.
Well, I guess from outsiders like us looking in, you've almost got to contribute that to the 2-3 zone.
Yeah, I don't know what else it would be.
Rochester starts with the basketball. Garrett goes to the top to Medina. Medina holds in the left wing, tries to feed it down low into a triple team. Pass is knocked away. Cassin has it. Douglas middle of the floor. Quentin with the basketball. Works to the right side. Spin move in the lane. Travels.
But there you go. You see he's trying to create something for himself. And in doing so, it creates opportunities for the rest of the guys because he can dish it off as well as anybody.
You could tell that his output in the first half was discussed at halftime.
Yeah, I think you're right.
Full court press by the Comets. Kennedy over the top to Gehrig. Gehrig drives it. Raises up off the window, it's good.
And Gehrig is having a very good basketball game. He's done a great job of getting himself in a position where he needs to be to score.
Rochester up 25-12. Quentin Douglas with the basketball between the rings, drives it right side to Kingery. He drives the baseline, cut off by the double team, and his pass is picked off by Gehrig. Alec Gehrig, crossover dribble, works it through the center circle. Now to the left side, now to Kennedy high on the left side. Kennedy back to Screeton. Rochester resets up 25-12 with a minute gone here in the third quarter. Kasten also in that 2-3 zone. Now right side to Holland. Holly about 6 feet behind the arc to Screeton, top of the key. Screeton looking at the elbow to Kennedy. Can't find him. Now to Holland. Baseline to Medina. Medina dribbles out to the wing to Holland. Now to Gehrig on the right wing behind the arc.
Probably a good move by Kasten. Slip into that 2-3 zone. Try and increase their numbers and get some defensive rebounds and make things a little more difficult for Kennedy and Gehrig down low.
Well, I think that Cass is saying right now, and I know you just said that, but if you're going to beat me, do it from behind the arc.
Right.
And they're doing a great job taking away the bigs. Kennedy for three in the baseline off the side of the backboard. No good. And Quentin Douglas drives in the corner to Kingery. Three in the way from the baseline. Nope. And the weak side rebound to Hadashell for Kasten. And then the pass by Quentin Douglas goes over the top and tipped out of bounds by Gehrig.
Well, I think another thing that Quentin Douglas needs to be aware of is if the more of the Rochester defense he can get focusing on him, the more of his teammates are going to be open.
Right. Quentin Douglas gets the inbounds pass from Jellison. And through the center circle he comes. Rochester still in that 2-3 zone. They have not come out of that 2-3 zone tonight.
Yeah, and they've played it very well. It's
not been
a lazy zone at all.
Quentin Douglas, baseline to Kingery. Kingery against the double team, tries to drive around it, throws the basketball out of bounds, last touch by Gehrig, and it's going to stay right in front of the Kasten bench. Jellison to trigger it in. Gets it into Quentin Douglas, crossover dribble, pass down to Jellison against the triple team, and we're going to have a 3-second call on Rochester. Good defense by Screeton, Kennedy, and Gehrig.
Yeah, once that ball went down low, they collapsed down in on the ball, and there wasn't anything that Jellison could do. He got called for the 3-second on the baseline.
5.5 to play, third quarter, 25-12. Kasten in a full court press, and they got to get it across. Holland's got to get it across over the top of the defense to Screeton. Screeton, left side to Gehrig. Gehrig with the basketball, backs it out and resets for Rochester.
Wow, they had Gehrig Medina. They had Medina wide open down low. He really worked hard to get himself in a scoring position, and nobody saw him.
Even against the 2-3 zone.
Yeah.
Holland holds high on the right side for Rochester, down to 5 to play in the third. Rochester up 25-12. Gehrig now with the basketball high on the left side, now right side to Screeton. Screeton over the top of the defense to Gehrig. Alec, one dribble. Wrap around pass to Screeton on the near side. Baseline to Medina, now to Holland. Holland against the double team. One dribble now to Medina on the wing, outside to Screeton, quickly left side to Kennedy. Now Holland in the corner, dribbles to the wing and resets for Rochester. Looks at a three, passes it up now to Screeton. Right side to Medina. Medina to the baseline to a cutting Kennedy. Jumper in the lane is no good. And Garrett comes flying through the lane, but I think he was helped a little bit, and he's pushing the back, I believe. It's going to be a foul cast and out of bounds to Rochester.
Offenberger is going to pick up his second.
4:29 to play in the third. Rochester doing a great job tonight, working the ball, working, not settling from behind the three. Kennedy misses the jumper.
Good pass into Kennedy. He just wasn't able to make the little jumper. But yeah, you're right. They're doing a good job of working that ball from corner to corner without going over the top.
Right.
So
Kastner with it. Douglas, right side. To Kingery, elbow to Hadashell, to Douglas, to Offenberger for three. Nope. Rebounded Jellison. Ball tipped away. It's loose. Scramble for it. Actually, we'll see a scrum.
Yeah, everybody's on
and
the
floor. And it's tied up. And now we've got a technical foul on Hadashell. We got a technical foul coming against the cast of Comets. We'll wait. It will be on Alex Hadashell.
That's his third foul.
So Rochester should be shooting.
Technical foul called on.
And Kennedy will be doing so.
Alex Hadashell.
So more than likely, Coach Howell will go to the bench, and the substitute, Eli Douglas, will probably come in for Hadashell, I'm guessing. Kennedy's free throw is short. No legs, no flip. One more coming for the senior. Again, back into the game. Now it's Rensselaer and Eli Douglas. Hadashell and Jellison comes out. 4 minutes to play in the first half. 25-12 Rochester. And Kennedy at the line for one more free throw in the technical. Second one's good this time. Rochester has it at the timeline.
I was going to say, Kennedy normally an 81% free throw shooter.
Rochester has it after the technical foul. And Screen will look to get it in. 4 minutes exactly to play in the third quarter. Rochester by 14. 2-3 zone by the cast of Comets. Garrett around the defense. Jump pass to Screen on the near side. Screen pulls it out between the rings and resets. 2-3 zone, top of that is at the three-point line. Now Garrick holds at the volleyball line. Garrick, one dribble, dump pass to Kennedy. Turnaround jumper at the free throw line, off the back of the rim, no good. Rebound to Kasten. Quinton Douglas runs. Douglas hesitates, accelerates, throws up a shot. We're going to have a foul. And it's good. So Quinton Douglas gets the hoop and the harm, and he'll go to the line to shoot one with 3.5 to play in the third quarter.
Number 11, Quinton Douglas, and he's shooting one free throw.
Taylor Medina picks up that foul. Quinton Douglas at the line for one. Eyes it, flies it, yep. 26-15, Rochester on top. Full court press by the Comets. Kennedy, bounce pass around the defense to Screeton. Screeton in the lane, baseline to Medina, runs it, and foul the shot. Will it be on the floor or on the shot? I think he was trying to rise up, but he's got tough to do that with two cast of Comets on his back.
Well, Medina did a good job of getting his possession along the baseline and making the most out of it.
Shooting to number 12, Taylor Medina.
And Douglas going to pick up his second.
And Taylor Medina at the line to shoot two for the Zebras. First one on the way is good, and he'll have one more. The lead is back to 12, and one more freebie coming for Medina as Abbott will come back into the game if this free throw is made. Taylor ready. Eyes the second one. Lets it fly. Good again. So Abbott back in, and Medina will sit down. 28-15 Rochester, 3:20 to play in the third. Cast of basketball going to our left. Quinton Douglas on the run, crosses the timeline right, 2-3 zone still by the Zebra defense. Douglas upside to Eli Douglas. Now to Offenberger, runs a baseline, throws up a shot, it's no good. Kennedy rips the board and is fouled. A little frustration foul that time on Offenberger, and Rochester going to get it back.
Offenberger going to pick up his third.
Cast of foul, number 21.
Full court press by the Comets. Brandon Camp back into the game and Holland to come out. Nate Cousins, a 5'10 senior, comes in for the first time tonight for Caston. And Offenberger, like Brad just said, with three personals to sit down. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. 3:09 to play in the third. Rochester up by 13 at 28-15. Camp gets the inbounds pass from Screeton. Gives the head to Kennedy. Over the top of the defense to Gehrig. Gehrig to Screeton, too high. Ball tipped away. Caston has it. Cousins gives to Rensler. Caston runs to our left. Rensler behind the arc. The Quinton Douglas top of the key. Fakes it right. Drives it left. Jump pass in the corner to Eli Douglas. Three on the way over the defense is no good. Gehrig with the rebound. Alec Gehrig runs for Rochester. Middle of the floor. Leading by 13. Loses the handle and out over the back call. Quinton Douglas forces that turnover. And it's going to go back to the Caston Comets.
So that full court pressure by Caston causing some turnovers by Rochester.
And now Caston needs to convert some points.
Yeah, they haven't been able to convert it yet.
Eli Quinton, or Eli Douglas, that is. Right side to Kingery. Cut off by Kennedy on the baseline. Gives down a little Rensler. He's fouled on the shot. He'll go to the line to shoot two.
So Screeton going to pick up the foul.
Carter Screeton.
2:26 to play in the third. Rochester by 13 at 28-15. And at the line is Graham Rensler, a 6'2 junior for the Comets. And he'll have two shots. First one on the way is good. Graham had 13 in the JV contest tonight. One more coming for Rensler. Looking to cut this lead to 11. He does so with two freebies. Full court press by the Comets. 2:26 to play in the third. Inbounds pass to Camp. Gives the head to Kennedy. Kennedy with the basketball. Looking over the defense. Got to get it across the timeline. And it'll just cross before the 10-second count. Drives all the way into the paint. Out the street now. And he'll reset between the rings.
Caston's back to a man-to-man.
Yep. Right side to Gehrig. Gehrig. Dump pass to Kennedy. Luke on the blocks. Jumper on the way. No good, but a foul coming on Caston.
And that's Kennedy had the advantage down low. He just couldn't get the shot to fall.
You know, if you're a Zebra athlete or a Zebra basketball player and they go to that man-to-man, Luke Kennedy's mouth has got to start watering.
Yeah, you're right.
So Kennedy at the line to shoot two for the Zebras. First on the way for the senior is good. He'll have one more.
Well, ever since that three that he hit in the first quarter, it's been all free throws since then.
Taylor Medina will come back in after this made free throw. Second of the way for Kennedy is good again.
It's eight for Kennedy.
So Medina back in, also Basham back in. Gehrig and Kennedy is sit. 2:04 to play in the third. Rochester up by 13 again, 30-17. Congratulations to the Lady Zebras as they win a non-conference game tonight over the North Judson-St. Pierre Lady Blue Jays, 59-36. B. Pollock, Alexa Holland, and Becky Malko, all three in double digits tonight in that win.
Brandon Camp going to pick up a foul on the inbounds pass.
Yeah, that was a headsy, smart veteran play by Quinton Douglas. He kind of stopped, and Camp had nowhere to go but over his
right
back.
On the top of him.
Douglas between the rings, 2-3 zone by the Zebras. Right side to Kingery, back to Quinton Douglas. Three in the way, top of the key for the Comets, short. And Kingery with the rebound. Kingery loses it, picks it up, and gives it back to Douglas. Lob pass in the corner to Rensler. He'll fire a three. It's good. And the lead is down to 10. 30-20. Camp holds. Now to Medina. Medina ahead to Abbott. Abbott holds in the corner, looks back door to Screeton. He dribbles out of trouble with 1:18 to play in the third. 30-20. Rochester leading the basketball. Medina holds in the right corner. One dribble to the wing. Now to Abbott. Top of the key to Camp. Camp left side to Kennedy. Or make that Screeton. He drives the baseline. Cut off on the defense. And to Basham. Top to Medina. Right side to Camp. Camp to Screeton. Three. Top of the key. Nope. Rebound fall for her. Medina's going to tip it out of bounds. And it's going to go back to Cap. Nope. It's going to stay with Rochester. Holland back in. Kennedy will come back in.
Also number 40, Luke Kennedy.
57.3 to play in the third. Rochester by 10. And the Zebras of the basketball baseline right. Kennedy lobs it into Kennedy. Medina lobs it into Kennedy. and while in the air, puts it in for two. And he's got 10.
An easy shot for Kennedy.
Douglas, Quentin, that is, between the rings. No look pass to Cousins, who gives to Kingery. Back to Quentin Douglas. Jump stops in the lane. Kicks it out to Eli. Quentin, baseline to Rensselaer. Back to Eli on the left side. High on the left side with 35. Three in the way for the youngster. He is off the mark. No good. Offensive rebound for the Comets. Cousins' put back is no good. Ball tipped around. Out of bounds. Last touch by the Zebras. Comets will keep it underneath their own basket. 25 seconds to play in the third. Rochester by 12 at 32-20. And bashing back into the game. Alec Garrett coming back into the game.
Returning to the floor for the Zebras, number 24. Alec.
Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. Kingery will look to trigger it in, baseline right. Kingery over the top of the defense to Quentin Douglas at the volleyball line. 22 seconds, no look pass to Cousins. He is swatted out of bounds by Basham, and it'll stay with Kasten.
Cousins did a good job of sneaking in behind that zone, and Douglas did a great job of finding him, but Basham recovered and put the shot out of bounds.
20 seconds to play. Inbounds pass goes to Douglas near the Rochester free throw line. And he'll cross the timeline to Eli Douglas. Back to Quentin Douglas with 15. Drives it. Lets her fly. Off the glass. No good. Camp with the rebound and runs with 9. Camp left side of the floor with 8. Over the defense to Garrick with 4. Garrick jump pass outside to Screeton with 1. 3 on the way is no good. But a foul coming on Kingery. And while shooting, Screeton will go to the line to shoot 3 free throws with 0.2 to play. In the first, in the third quarter.
Not a good foul by Kingery.
No.
At the line for the Zebras should be 3.
And I'm guessing that's exactly what Coach Howell's thinking, too.
Yeah.
So Carter Screeton at the line to shoot 3.
First one's good.
First one is good. One more coming for Screeton. Looking to push this lead to 14. He's got 3 free throws. The first one's good with 2 more coming. Second one for the senior is good again. And it's 34-20. One more coming. Screen's numbers tonight?
He's got 5 right now.
Okay. Hit a big 3 in the first quarter. Screeton with 1 more. Second one, no good. The putback of the buzzer's no good.
Wow.
After 3, Rochester leads the cast of Comets 34-20. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Being incarcerated is never easy on you or your family. When you need a bail bond, count on the other dog in town, Fulton Bail Bond. Licensed bonding agent Jeff Fulton is ready to post your bond 24 hours a day, 366 days per year. Call Fulton Bail Bonds when you need action fast. Locally owned and operated, Fulton Bail Bonds is a professional service always here to serve you.
Introducing Gourmet On The Go from Giretti's Catering. Now enjoy that gourmet taste anywhere for any number of people. Box lunches, party platters, dessert trays, and more. Only from the place for gourmet, Giretti's Place. Feed the team. Impress the clients. Whatever the reason, Giretti's Catering is the answer. Stop in today to pick up our new catering menu. Gourmet On The Go. Only from Giretti's Catering.
Fourth quarter we go at Rochester High School. The Zebras lead 34-20. The Comets with the basketball going to our left. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. Quentin Douglas holds against a 2-3 zone. Eli Douglas, now to Rensselaer. Drives the baseline, loses the handle. Grabs the basketball. Now to Offenberger, who's back in the game. To Kingery. Kingery directs traffic to Rensselaer. Down low, jumper over Dahlquist is no good. Gerger grabs the board.
He just about missed time,
yeah,
but he was
right.
Long enough to be able to still get the board.
Congratulations to the Lady Zebras as they win one on the road tonight against North Judson, 59-36. B. Pollock was 16, Alexa Holland a 15, and Becky Malco went for 14 tonight for the Zebras. Garrick's layup in the lane is good, and Rochester out to a 16-point lead, biggest of the night.
Garrick now with 10 points.
Quentin Douglas has the basketball, backs it out, resets for the cast of Comets, now works left side to Eli Douglas, now to Rensselaer in the wing. Rensselaer with the basketball. Runs around Brandon Camp. Now to Eli Douglas. Right side to Kingery. Kingery holds and studies. Runs around screen to Eli Douglas. Three on the way. Top of the key is off the mark. No good. The putback by Kingery is good. Make the Offenberger.
Offenberger with a great effort.
36-22. Somebody forgot to put a butt on Offenberger.
Kind of snuck in down the baseline.
And a lot of contact coming up the floor. And Garrick loses his balance and travels. Right side is Kingery. Rochester in a 2-3 zone and have been for the entire evening. High on the right side. Now over the defense to Quentin Douglas. Quentin Douglas to Offenberger. To Kingery behind the arc in the corner. And then Carter Screen is going to be called for a foul. And it'll be out of bounds to cast it on the far side.
Screen will pick up his second. Team fourth.
Earlier tonight, the freshman in the freshman game, Rochester defeated Caston 40-27. The JV contest went to Rochester over Caston 47-30. And the varsity looking to complete the trifecta here. Quentin Douglas runs the point. Rochester in a 2-3 zone to Offenberger just inside the arc. Out to Quentin Douglas between the rings and the volleyball line. Drives, kicks it out. Offenberger for three. Before the shot, I think we're going to have a foul in Rochester.
Yep.
As Screen tried to set up for the charge, and I don't think he's going to get it.
Yep. That's his third.
Offenberger looks to trigger it in. Gets it to Quentin Douglas. Leaner in the way is no good, but a foul coming on Kennedy. That's going to send Quentin Douglas to the line to shoot two.
Kennedy will pick up his third.
6-11 to play in the game. Rochester by 14, and Quentin Douglas will go to the line to shoot two, who's had an awfully quiet night tonight for the cast of Comets.
Got 6 points right now.
Douglas eyes the first one, flies it. Nope. We'll have one more. Well, I'm impressed. Coach Reinhold has not sat down tonight. He's battling the flu.
Yeah. Are you going to talk to him after the game?
I hope not. I didn't really want to talk to him before the game.
Get you one of those painter masks.
It'll be you and Tony Friday night.
Yeah, there you go.
Douglas at the line to shoot one more. Second on the way is good this time.
Don't tell Tony, he'll have the flu Friday night.
Yeah, the phantom flu.
Yeah.
36-23, Rochester on top, breaks the press. Kennedy around the defense, goes to the baseline. Oh, had a wide open shot to the basket and turned it down and kicked it out. Now Garrick has it and he'll reset. Right wing is Garrick, now to Screeton. Screeton against Hadashell, and he is fouled going to the basket.
Hadashell picking up his fourth.
And both teams will shoot free throws from here on out as Screeton will go there to shoot one and the bonus.
Alec Hadashell. Shooting one and one.
As the third quarter came to an end, he was shooting three free throws, hit two of three. Screeton's first one short. Rebound fought for, out of bounds. Dina's going to touch it last and cast him to get it back. 5:49 to play in the game. Rochester up 36-23. This is where it's been virtually the second half, around that 10 to 13 point mark.
Yeah, you're right. Rochester did a great job in the first quarter and the first part of the second quarter of really just taking Caston completely off the floor.
Offenberger's three is no good, but a foul to put back is good. And a free throw coming for Jellison. Is that foul coming on Luke Kennedy? Look out.
Kennedy, that's his fourth.
Jellison at the line to shoot one free throw. Looking to cut this lead to 10. Bad shot. Rebound to Garrick, who loses the basketball to Offenberger. Offenberger steals it, gives it to Quentin Douglas. Caston with an opportunity here to cut this inside 10 for the first time in a long time. Quentin Douglas then has it stolen. Camp, left-handed block by Quentin Douglas. Safe from going out of bounds by Eli. Nope, he's going to say steps on the sideline. Rochester going to keep possession. Nice recovery by Quentin Douglas, who swatted that thing into the first row of the student section.
Yeah, he did a really good job. He come in from the opposite side of the lane and was able to get up underneath the basketball.
Thought he's going to hit his head on the basket.
On the rim.
Straighten looks to get it in. Does so to Medina. Medina back to Garrick. 36-25 Rochester, 4:15 to play in the game. Garrick backs his way in. Now we're going to have a charge coming against Alec Garrick.
Garrick got the elbow out there in front, making a little room for himself as he come across the top of the key.
So Cassidy going to get it back down by 11. And Quentin Douglas works against Camp in the backcourt. Rochester still in that 2-3 zone. Camp with the basketball, make that Douglas with the basketball. Jellison, Offenberger stops, rises up, shot short. Garrick with the board.
I'm not so sure Garrick didn't step on the baseline, but the referee missed it.
Apparently the fans behind us thought that Garrick got away with a push or an elbow. And then Houdeshell picks up a foul for the cast of Comets. Is that five?
I've got him for five. Yep,
so to shape. Rochester will use a 60-second timeout. You're listening to Zebra Basketball on 82.1 WROI.
Giretti's Place is the place for gourmet catering. Enjoy the finest dining experience delivered to your next party or event. Giretti's extensive catering menu will satisfy everyone's taste. Complete with entrees, sides, salads, and dessert, you simply can't beat Giretti's Catering. Now taking orders for the holiday season and beyond. Call Giretti's Place today to book your next catered event. Giretti's Place, the place for gourmet.
RC has officially invited, or offered membership, I should say, to Peru Meconicwall. And the TRC has officially offered membership to Peru Meconicwall. They have until April 1st to make a decision. It must be a package deal. Both or none. Or both or neither, I should say. Screen's free throw no good. Cassa comes out of the rebound. Offenberger brings it up the floor against Basham. Outside to Quentin Douglas. Quentin in the lane, rises up, shot no good, but a foul coming on Rochester. And Quentin Douglas will go back to the line to shoot two.
That foul's coming against Basham.
Shooting
his second.
For Gaston, number 11, Quentin Douglas.
Douglas with seven tonight, looking for two more.
4:43 to play in the game. Douglas with an opportunity to cut this one inside double digits. First one is no good. He'll have one more. 6 foot senior, struggling right now from the line.
Yeah, he's 2 of 3, 2 of 4.
Second one, short. And now we're going to have a rebound by Offenberger. And is that, if that's so, it's going to be four.
Offenberger.
And that's going to send Matt Basham to the line to shoot one of the bonus. Here at Rochester High School, 4:43 to play in the game. Rochester by 11. Last couple of minutes, it hasn't been real pretty either way.
No, back and forth from the free throw line.
Kingery back in the game, and Offenberger with four is coming out.
So how do you feel about that invitation?
I'm all right with that.
I am too.
Free throw by Basham is no good. And the rebound to Garrick. Garrick pulls out to Straighten. Quickly in the corner to Holland. Holland, one dribble. Top to Garrick. Drives around the defense. Jumps it out to Medina on the right wing. Top to Basham. Between the rings. Top the key to Garrick. At the elbow. Out to Holland now. Rochester resets. Casting still in that 2-3 zone. I should say back in that 2-3 zone. Garrick around the defense. Now at the elbow, pulls it out with 4:15 to play in the game. Rochester by 11. Screeting high on the left side to Holland. Oh, boy, I think he did not travel. To Garrick, to Screeton. Whoa, Dina is working hard on the box. You got to give that boy the ball. Left side to Holland for three, left wing. No good, short. And the rebound to Jellison. Jellison, left side of the floor, gives out to Eli Douglas. Jump pass to Quentin Douglas. And the lane to Jellison. Back door to Rensselaer, and knocked out of bounds by Rochester. And it'll be cast in basketball with 3:44 to play in the game. 36-25 Rochester. Kingery gets it over the top to Douglas. Three over Holland is good. And it's 36-28. Basham gets it into Garrick. Garrick with the basketball, ahead to Screeton. Screeton with the numbers in the middle of the lane to Holland. Layup on the way is no good, but a foul coming on Casson. And Alec Holland will go to the line to shoot two.
So, foul coming on Jellison, his first. Holland at the line to shoot two. Rochester with just one field goal in the fourth quarter, and they've missed three attempts at free throws.
Holland's free throws no good.
Wow,
fourth, really?
Fourth missed.
Schaefer. 3:29 to play in the basketball game. Rochester has three timeouts left. Caston has four. One more coming for Holland. Second one for the sophomore is good. And Cam back in. Holland to sit. Rochester's lead is now 9. 3:29 to play in the game. Just when he thought Brad Rochester had an opportunity to run away and hide.
Yeah.
Caston battles back.
They have. And, you know, Rochester with just 3 points here in the fourth quarter. And it's been the foul situations that's helped Caston come back.
And Carter Screeton just picked up another foul, and they'll send Caston to the line to shoot two.
That's four on Screeton. So Screeton and Kennedy both with four for Rochester.
Kingery for two. First one is good. Kennedy will come back into the game with four personal fouls, and Basham will come out.
The power Kennedy checking in for his
3:23 to play in the game. One more coming for Kingery. Second one is good as it bounces high off the back of the rim and goes through. The lead is 8 for Rochester. Garrick. Bounce pass into Kennedy. Full court press by the Comets. Kennedy around the defense ahead to Camp. And then Camp fouls Jellison. And that's going to send Jellison to the line for shoot two.
And that full court pressure by Caston's really been the difference here in the second half.
Well, here's what I don't
the
get there.
Quarter.
They get it into Kennedy, yeah. And then the guards run away from him.
Then he's left alone.
Yeah.
Shooting two for Caston, number 40.
3:16 to play in the game. Caston with an opportunity here to cut this to 5. The first one by Jellison's no good. It's 37-30. Rochester the lead. Holland and Abbott will come back into the game. And Camp and Medina will sit. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. 3:16 to play in the game. Rochester by 7. And Jellison for the cast of Comets with one more freebie. Second one on the way. Good this time. Rochester's lead, once of 16, is down to 6. Screeton around the defense. Works against Rensselaer, yeah.
Caston's outscored Rochester 11-3 in the fourth quarter.
Yeah. Screeton dribbles to the baseline, cut off by the double team. Going to have to
call.
And now we're going to have a 30-second timeout taken by the Zebras. You're listening to High School Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
At Shepherd Chevrolet Buick in Rochester, it's our customers that come first.
The sales process was very simple, very easy. It's a very nice and friendly atmosphere. They've always worked with me on my trades and what I bought. There wasn't any haggling. It's where I really wanted to be, and I would keep coming back.
Stop out today and let Shepherds help you find your next vehicle.
Come on. 3 minutes to play in the game. Rochester by 6, Screeton in the right corner. Dribbles to the wing and will reset top of the key against Caston's man-to-man defense. And now Jellison going to pick up the foul and Screeton will go to the line to shoot two.
Second foul on Jellison.
At the line and shooting two for the Zebras, number 20.
Things are starting to get a little chippy.
Yeah, getting down towards the end of this ball game, and Caston's finding themselves with a lot more confidence here in the last
absolutely
four or five minutes than what they've had for the whole first three quarters.
Screen's free throw is good. Basham will come back in, and Kennedy will come out. One more coming for Screeton, looking to push this back to an 8-point lead for the Zebras with 2:54 to play in the game. Screeton ready. Eyes it. Flies it. Good. Offenberger back into the game with four fouls. Rensselaer to sit. 39-31 Rochester. 2:54 to play in the game. Quentin Douglas on the run for the Comets. Going to our left. Douglas high on the right side. Over the top of the defense to Eli Douglas. Down low to Offenberger. Offenberger blocked by Garrick. Picked up by Screeton. Now Screeton runs. Lobs ahead to Garrick. Left side to Abbott. Abbott back to Garrick high on the left side. Garrick around the defense, the screen on the near side. And now we're going to have a foul down low by Offenberger. And if it's so, that's five.
That is five.
And Matt Basham will go to the line to shoot two.
Comet Powell, number 21, Dustin Offenberger. Shooting two for the Zebras, number 32, Matt Basham.
So Offenberger will finish with 5 points for the Comets.
Back on the floor with the Zebras, number two.
So Rensler back on the floor.
Comets, number three.
For Kasten.
Rensler.
And Camp back on the floor for Rochester, and two free throws coming for Matt Basham. With an opportunity to stretch this back to double digits. First one by the big guy is good. 2.5 to play in the game. Rochester back by 9. One more coming for Basham. Second one. Good again. 41-31. Rochester by 10 with 2.5 to play in the game. Quinton Douglas ahead to Kingery. Down low to Rensler. Foul on the shot. He'll go to the line to shoot two. Good heavens.
Good thing both teams dressed 10 or 11 kids.
Yeah, no kidding.
Number two, Brandon King.
So Camp going to pick up his third.
Number three, Greg Rensler.
Rensler at the line to shoot two. First one by the Southpaw is good. Kennedy and Holland back in. Cam and Basham out. 2:26 to play in the game. One more coming for Rensler, looking to cut this to 8. Second one is no good. Garrick with the rebound and steps out of bounds. Nice job by Eli Douglas.
Pushing him down. Yeah. Pushing him low and didn't have room to get both feet in bounds.
Medina back in.
Back with the Zebras.
Kennedy to come out.
Taylor Medina.
41-32 Rochester. Kasten basketball baseline left. Kingery look to get it in. DeSoto Jonathan, his layup is good. Lead is down to 7. Holland crosses the timeline, breaks the press. Gives to Screeton. Screeton in the paint. Rides it to the corner. Got to get rid of it. Does to Garrick. Garrick loses it. And now we're going to have a foul coming against Kasten. And Garrick will go to the line to shoot two. And that foul going to come against
Jellison.
Number 40.
Yep.
Break. Jellison.
Garrick at the line to shoot two for Rochester.
Alec Garrick.
Oh, Alec. Oh, he gets it to roll over the front of the rim and go through. We have one more.
Leg's getting a little tired.
Yeah, I think so. 2:06 to play in the basketball game. Rochester up 42-34. And one more coming for Alec Garrick. Second one for the senior is good as it rattles in. 9-point lead for the Zebras. Quinton Douglas runs it for Kasten. Through the center circle, right side of the floor now. To Jellison at the elbow. Kicks it to Eli Douglas for three. Is short. And the rebound fall for Abbott comes out of there with it to Medina. Medina to Garrick. Rochester runs up by 9. Garrick in the corner to Holland. Fakes the three. Drives it to the wing. Bounce pass top to Medina, who gives to Abbott. Now to Screeton high on the left side of the minute 40 to play. In the corner to Garrick. Alec Garrick against the double team to Screeton high on the left side with 90 seconds to play. And he is fouled by Quinton Douglas. And Screeton will go back to the line to shoot two for the Zebras.
Douglas will pick up his third.
Comet foul, number 11, Quinton Douglas.
Camp will come in after the first free throw by Screeton, who's got to be approaching double digits.
He's got 7.
Okay. Screeton's free throw is good. We'll have one more. Kennedy and Camp back in.
Checking back in with the Zebras.
Holland and Abbott to come out. Minute 34 to play in the game. Rochester by 10. Screen with an opportunity to push this one to 11. Second one for the senior. Good again. He's got 9. And Rochester in his 11-point lead. Quinton Douglas runs for the Comets, going to our left. Douglas will go all the way to the rack. Throws up a shot over Kennedy, and it goes. Timeout Kasten. They'll take a 60. You're listening to high school basketball. 92.1 WROI. Thank you.
Katie Seiler, 2013 graduate of Rochester High School. The Babcock Scholarship was established by Charles and Elizabeth Babcock for Rochester High School students and graduates. Juniors and seniors interested in taking dual credit classes and applying for the Babcock Scholarship can pick one up at Mrs. Horn's desk. If you are a junior or senior taking dual credit classes, don't hesitate to fill out the Babcock Scholarship. In the past, all applicants have received money to help fund their education.
After the timeout, cast into the full court press, Kennedy has it. He gives it head to Screeton. Minute 20 to play in the ball game. Rochester by 9. Garrick around the defense, foul going to the basket. He'll go to the line to shoot 2, and that foul coming, it looks like, again, against Nate Cousins. And Alec Garrick will go to the line to shoot two free throws, looking to push this back to a double-digit lead.
Garrick with 12 points on the night tonight.
Alec, one dribble, free throw, good. Eli Douglas back in, and Cousins to sit down. One minute, 18 seconds to play in the game. Rochester by 10. And Garrick for the Zebras with one more. Second one is good again. 47-36 Rochester. Quentin Douglas on the run. Douglas, middle of the floor, pull up 3 on the way. Good!
All right, wasn't doing that all night long.
Yeah.
He now has 15.
47-39 Rochester. 65 seconds to play in the game. Camp loses his footing and travels.
So Douglas now with 15, 9 of those in the fourth quarter.
I'm guessing we're going to see that here for another 62 seconds.
Yeah.
Man, that was smooth. Douglas grabs the inbounds pass, crosses the timeline right, crossover dribble, middle of the floor. Long 3 is short. And the rebound to Screeton, and Douglas is going to pick up foul number 4. And Carter Screeton will go to the line to shoot 1 in the bonus. Okay. I'm sorry. Screeton's going to go to the line to shoot 2. 47-39 Rochester.
At the line.
Screeton 56 seconds to play in the game, and Screeton with 2 freebies.
9 points on the night. He's 4 of 6 from the line in the fourth quarter.
First one for the senior is good. Down doubles.
Yep. It's the third one.
He, Garrick, and Kennedy.
Yep. You're good.
Shot in the dark. Second one is short. The rebound to Jollison. Jellison gives off to Quentin Douglas with 50. Quentin Douglas in the paint. Kicks out to Eli Douglas. Now to Jellison. Right side to Kangaroo with 45. Kangaroo stops. Shot blocked. Picked up by Camp, and he is fouled immediately by Kangaroo. And Brandon Camp will go to the line to shoot 2 with 41.6 to play in the game.
Just a second foul on Kangaroo.
Number 13, Jake Kangaroo.
Holland will come back into the game for Rochester.
Shooting 2, number 2, Brandon Camp.
Camp with the line for 2 for the Zebras. Eyes the first one, flies it, get there, short. He'll have one more. Holland will replace Camp if he makes his second free throw. And with the second free throw, could push the lead back to double digits. Second one for Camp, good again, or good this time. So Holland back in, Camp out. 49-39 Rochester with 41.6 to play in the game.
Rochester with just 1 field goal in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, as long as he keeps hitting free throws.
13 free throws, though. Yep.
Douglas to the rack, finger rolls short. Kennedy with the board. And he is drugged down from behind by Jollison, I think. He hit the floor hard. He's slow to get up. And we've got a... one official saying out of bounds. We've got 2 officials saying a foul. And it's going to be
on Jellison.
A foul on Jellison.
His fourth.
And Luke Candy will go to the line to shoot 2 free throws with 31.8 to play in the game with Rochester up by 10.
Shoot for the rim in the middle.
Going to the line for the Zebras. Shooting 2, number 4.
Kind of holding his head a little bit.
Yep.
So Luke Kennedy at the line for 2 freebies for the Rochester Zebras, who lead by 10 with 31.8 to play in the game.
10 points in the game for Kennedy tonight. Those are his first points in the fourth quarter.
He hits on his first one. He'll have one more. Dahlquist will come back in if Kennedy can make this second free throw. Brett Abbott will come in after this free throw as well. Second one for Luke on the way. Good again. Luke is probably done. Dahlquist was in. Medina is probably done. Abbott is in. 31.8 to play in the game. Rochester by 12. And Douglas lets the ball roll, picks it up, crosses the timeline, middle of the floor, outside to Jellison. Long three for the Comets. No good. And the rebound to Gehrig. Baseball passed ahead to Holland. Holly, left-handed layup. Good. 18 seconds. Douglas in the paint. Stops. Jumper. Good. A foul.
Gaston Baskin, number 11.
Coach Reinholt looks at the guys on the opposite end of the floor and say, why would you do that? We're up by 14. Why in the world did you foul? Just let him go. 12.5 to play in the game. Quinton Douglas at the line to shoot one free throw, looking to cut this lead to 11. Douglas eyes the free throw, and it's good. Basham in, and Gehrig is done. Camp is in. Straighten is done. 12.5 to play in the game. Rochester up 53-42, and Rochester's basically emptied their bench.
Douglas now with 18 points, 12 of which came in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, I knew he had an awfully quiet game until this fourth.
Yeah.
Holland gets it across with four, with three, with two, with one, and that'll do it. The Rochester Zebras defeat the Cass Comets tonight, 53-42. You're listening to High School Basketball, 92.1 WROI. High School Wishes.